Hey everyone, I'm Greg Tatum and I work on the Firefox Dev Tools on the memory and performance tools. And I kind of want to show off some of the features of the performance tools and how they can kind of help you out when you're wanting to debug your application. And so I have this visualization code that I was writing. And this is the code as it runs right now. And basically it just draws some lines on the screen using a 2D canvas and kind of it works off some simple rules. So basically you draw a line and it kind of wanders around the screen and there's a bunch that wander at the same time. And if two are coming across and then one intersects with the other one, there's a collision event and it stops drawing. And then a new line somewhere else inside kind of this diamond shape will keep on moving through. And as you can see, kind of as it runs, it starts to build up this cool shape. So just something kind of fun I put together using like the 2D canvas. But the problem was is that when I was first writing it, I started getting some real bad performance issues. So this is kind of an earlier version of this visualization. And as you can see, it's starting to slow down quite a bit. So what's going on here? There could be a few things going on. So basically, there's a lot of lines. So each of these little line segments is an array. So it has to go through each of those lines and check to see if there's a collision. And I put some optimizations in there to try to fix that. So let's just use the developer tools to figure out if we can isolate this problem. So what I'm gonna do is I have the performance tab here. I'm gonna click start recording performance and I'm gonna do a quick refresh. And you see that little refresh happened here, and right here is the frame rate. It starts close at 60 frames per second and then quickly dives down to, like right now saying average is 12, 11. It gets worse and worse and worse. So there's an issue somewhere in how my code is running. So I'm gonna stop recording the performance and I'm gonna click over to the JS flame chart because this is gonna be a more helpful view for us. And let me go ahead and zoom in on one of these problem areas. So if you see right here, I've got this paint right here, event that's going on. And I have show gecko platform data on. So if I turn that off, it just says graphics. So something's going on with graphics. I'm using 2D canvas. And then let's zoom in, loop call in my draw call. And that's a much smaller slice right there. And let's zoom in, like when I first start this visualization, you can see my graphics relative to the rest of the call is a lot shorter. So let me go one more view to just get you a little bit of orientation here. You can see each of these lines is basically a frame drawing and it gets slower and slower and slower. So the graphics code is what's causing the issue with this application. So looking at the code, there's going to be an issue with the drawing. So let's look at the original slow version. So you see here, here's my draw function, which just says, which just runs in a loop basically, using a request animation frame. First thing I do is clear the frame and I draw the lines with my current context, with how my configuration options are, and then my current set of lines. And it goes through every single line and redraws it on the screen. Well, that is what appears to be the issue, is that we're redrawing the screen every single frame. So maybe we should get rid of this clear rectangle and only draw the lines that are new. So if you look at the new draw call, you see it's just this function. And you'll notice that there's no clearing anymore. And I have this little ternary that says if I want to redraw everything, take my graph and then use the lines. Otherwise, take my graph and use my new lines. So by default, it only draws the new lines unless like you're resizing the page and it needs to redraw everything. So essentially, it goes from having to draw, you know, potentially 10,000 lines to drawing just 10 lines per frame. So when we go back to our new optimized code, let's go ahead and start recording this performance, and I will refresh the screen. And as more and more lines come on, it's a little bit choppy because I'm recording my screen at the same time, more so than it would be otherwise. But you see it maintains a pretty good frame rate, and I can keep on drawing and drawing and drawing, and it doesn't really slow down, which lets me do a lot more cool things with how I want to put the lines on the screen. Let's here stop recording and go back to that JS flame chart, and let's go into one of those nice clear areas to see what it looks like now. So actually, I'm going to zoom out a little bit. You can see each of these little lines right here is a frame update. So tick, tick, tick. Moving along, and there's this little gecko thing, which just means basically it's back to the platform side and not doing any work on our code. And so if I zoom in right here, you see my loop is taking probably the most time, and then my graphics actually drawing, actually to see this intersects is now, as it makes sense, like that's taking the most time. And then the graphics is not taking hardly any at all, which is what we want. That's good. And it lets you kind of play around with this idea and draw a lot more lines at once so you can get much crazier visualizations. So this is just kind of one example using performance tools, how you can look at code as you're writing it. And what I like to do is not pre-optimize my code. I don't like to think of everything of like, how is this code completely slow? Write something that is easy to maintain and makes sense, and then profile it, take a look at how it's performing, find those slow points, because a lot of times the slow points are in something really simple to factor out. And using like the performance tools, you can identify exactly what's happening in your code and what's causing those issues. Well, thanks for listening to me ramble on about these tools. I hope you enjoyed it and hope it was helpful.